I would often wander around the lake during the night. It was so silent there. I would just sit at the base of the water and listen to the nothingness that surrounded me. My mind would drift into peaceful thoughts those nights, and I never expected to see anything in the lake other than the pure reflection of the shimmering moon. But there was one night that I'll always remember in my mind. I began my walk to the lake on a cold autumn night. The wind was strong adrift and pressing on me. I held my head down to keep my face out of the gust and walked as quickly as I could to my spot. The lake was located within the forest, so the many trees offered nice protection from the inclement weather. When I finally made it there, I slid off my boots and my socks and threw them to my side, and I sat at the edge of the water, staring out into the empty crystalline form that the lake had taken. As my eyes sunk into the vast escape of the water, I noticed a single flaw within. I had stared many times out of the lake, and never had I seen this form. At the center of the lake was some type of black lump popping out of the water. I looked closer at it and saw it was moving ever so slightly. It was around in a circle, almost as if it was dancing from underneath. Whatever the lump was, it had to be living. I had a feeling in my gut. I stood up and tried to call it, try to see if it responded. It did. The lump stopped moving. It seemed to turn to me and stay in place. I called it again and was waiting for it to sink under the water. To my surprise, the lump started to swim over towards me. I took a few steps back to be cautious, but my heart sank when I saw it emerge. The lump began to rise from the water, and I had the sudden realization of what I was looking at. The lump was the top part of a black head of hair. The hair belonged to a beautiful woman who now stood on the surface of the water looking in my direction. Her skin was a white, luminescent color that reflected the gorgeous moonlight off of itself. Her hair was long and black and stretched down all the way to her feet. As captivated as I was by her and her wholesome naked body, I became distressed when I saw her lift her head up and part her strands that covered her face. Underneath the veil of black cords was a ghostly looking face. It was paler than her entire body, and her lips were a cold blue. Her eyes looked directly into mine, and all I could see was an empty white abyss. She entranced me, and as she stood still atop the water, I called out to her again, and I began to hear a song. It rushed into my ears from the trees like the wind and echoed throughout my soul. The song carried a heavenly key to it and made my body feel weak. My knees buckled when I stood, and I fell down, still looking at her. She opened her mouth to imitate the motion of singing, and that was when the song stopped. The song, along with every other conceivable sound, stopped. I could hear nothing. All that I saw was her standing a few feet from me, mimicking the sounds of music that should be heard. Her eyes were like white pearls in an empty ocean, and as she lifted her right hand towards me, my throat began to close. My breathing was tightening, and it felt like my lungs were being filled with water. I wanted to cough it up, but the tightness in my throat stopped me. Her feet swayed towards me across the lake, and with every step she took, my throat became tighter, and I struggled to get even an ounce of oxygen into my lungs. Then, when she had stepped off of the lake and her foot touched the ground beside me, all desires to breathe left me. I no longer cared to struggle. I felt a peace that I had never experienced before. I was like an unborn child still in the womb. Before I knew what had happened, I was at the bottom of the ripping cold lake, holding her in my arms. The lady in the lake kissed me, and my lips felt like they had been frozen solid. Darkness followed her kiss, and then the light came along with my ability to hear. I was in my bed, next to my wife. Her warm body nestled against mine. She was still asleep, almost like an angel in my eyes. My clothes were soaking wet, and it did not take long for the water to soak into the bed and reach my wife, who woke up startled. Scared at first until her eyes met my own and she recognized me. She hugged me instantly and started to cry while telling me I had been missing for weeks. Her voice began to faint from my ears, and all I could hear was the calming singing again. All other sounds were static. A sudden urge emerged from within my heart As I threw my wife down onto the bed, I got on top of her as she struggled, and I wrapped my hands as tight as they would go around her neck. I could feel her attempt to swallow the blood and saliva building up in her mouth. The lump in her throat twitched repeatedly. The skin of her face went from a shade of red to blue. In a matter of seconds, the tears ran down her face. I could feel her nails dig into my arms, but this made me only squeeze tighter. I held onto her neck until she stopped kicking and all the life had faded from her eyes. Rage and jealousy faded from my body as my arms and hands went limp. Her body was already losing warmth, and the sound was coming back to me by the time I had let go of her neck. I heard the birds and the wind from outside, and my own sounds of crying replaced them. Warm tears ran down my face and hit her cheeks as I clutched her lifeless body in my arms. I cradled her like one would cradle a baby. Then I heard the whisper again. Join me. I await your touch. That night, under the cover of full moon, my body lost all emotion. I was not sad, anger did not consume me, and fear was non-existent. All I had in my mind was the image of the lady in the lake and her pale white skin. At the edge of the lake is where I stood. She rose from the water at the waist and waved me over towards her. My legs started to move on their own as I stared into her cold white eyes. I sunk into the water as its frigid claws scarred my bones. Then as my head was completely submerged under the water, I walked into the center of the lake and she was there to greet me. The sound faded from my ears, the color from my sight, and the warmth from my flesh. One last time, I looked into those eyes of hers, and everything faded away.